Rubbish! Rubbish!
Perhaps the Right Honourable Prime Minister would care to give this House and the nation reassurances about the security measures operating in this country at the present time, in the light of the current scandal in which the government finds itself, and the fact that its results have made a once proud Britain the laughing stock of the world.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Bad sense, Grace.
Prime Minister, wake up.
The following three men are homosexual spies working for England in Russia. I got the wrong piece of paper. It was with the deepest regret that I learned of the terrible news that has shocked this house in the nation and indeed the world. The news that a minister of my cabinet had committed a grave miscalculation with misdemeanor. First, yet, who never had it so good? I didn't mean that good. Those of you in this house who knew the ex-minister of horror.
War
has been declared. Don't forget, I was the first to tell you.
Yes, as I was saying,
those of you who knew him as well as I did must have known. Him. At least as well as I did. Know him. But when all is said and done, as most of us have been, there is really only one vital question to be answered. And that is, was there in fact any major security risk involved? Well, now, let us take a look at the facts. I've got them here somewhere. You see, the fact is that facts very seldom tell the whole story. I myself very seldom tell the whole story. And I am in complete control of the facts. But the facts are these. Operating in this country today is one of the finest secret services in the world. It belongs to the Russians.
It's an absolute disgrace! It's a disgrace!
Terrible. Let us not forget that the Russians could never have achieved this kind of efficiency without the fullest cooperation of the British secret service. I'd just like you to remember that. Now, you may ask, why is the Secret Service called the Secret Service? Well, now, I'm afraid that is a secret. What I can tell you is nothing of importance. Nothing of importance happens in the world today that isn't passed on to me by our intelligence, sooner or later. Sometimes, of course, I find out things before they do. In which case, I pass it on to them. And that is how we go along. They pass it on to me, and I pass it back to them. In passing, how delighted I am to see so many Conservative members here tonight. Thanks, no doubt, Joe, to the party whips. And may I hasten to add, when I say party whips, I don't mean party whips. I mean party whips.
Get out. Move.
I would inform those of my critics who have hinted that I should hand on the reins of office that I have anticipated their mood and that the winds of change are already blowing through Westminster. Even now, my chosen successor is on his way here to Metro, a man destined to take his place in history, just as surely as I am condemned to take mine. Now then, Sergeant at Arms.
Sir!
Throw wide the doors and bid the nation's new leader enter. If this is your idea of a joke, young Harold, I ought to be bloody well ashamed.